Welcome everyone. In today's video, I'll be talking about vector databases and how they solved a long-standing issue I faced with my YouTube channel. It's often difficult to find videos based on a concept. Typically, you can only find videos by a specific keyword. For instance, if I search for DevOps, I can only find videos with DevOps in the title, but not necessarily ones that cover the topic in depth but don't have the word DevOps in the title. How can we solve this? We can use DataStax AstraDB and Langflow. Let me show you how, but before we dive in, I need some data, specifically a CSV file containing all my YouTube videos. I've already made a video on how to do this, which you can check out in the link below. Essentially, I used the YouTube API and Rust to create a fetcher that compiles a CSV file with useful information about my videos. This tool is free, available for everyone, and can be used to fetch your videos too. So feel free to use it. Then you can go to datastax.com, create an account, and you should have an interface that looks similar to this. I already made some tries, so let's create a new project from scratch. And as a database, we will use AstraDB, which is a database provided by DataStax. Let's see the process together. Click Create a Database. You need a vector database. You can give it a name, for example, VideosDB.
And now let's dive into vector databases. What exactly is a vector database? In short, it's a database designed to handle vectorized data. This kind of data allows you to perform semantic searches, which means finding information not just by keywords, but by understanding the content and meaning behind it. This is exactly what we need to solve the problem of discovering relevant videos without relying purely on keywords. To solve my problem, I'll use DataStax and AstraDB. DataStax AstraDB is a cloud-native scalable database as a service built on Apache Cassandra. And Apache Cassandra is the open-source NoSQL database behind many large applications in the world, including Netflix, Instagram, and so on. Let's take a quick step back and discuss why we are using a vector database and what exactly vector embeddings are. For traditional databases, you search based on exact keywords or phrases. However, we can search semantically with vector databases and look up content based on the underlying meaning, not just specific words. Now, to make this happen, we use something called vector embeddings. Think of embeddings as numerical data representations, in our case of the video content itself. By translating concept or topics into these numeric vectors, we can perform much deeper searches that match similar topics or ideas, even if the exact words are not used. To create these embeddings, we use text embedding models from companies like OpenAI, Nvidia, and others. They take the text content, such as video, title, description, or transcripts, and they convert them into vector format. In the upcoming example, I ingested the list of videos as a text embedding 3 large model with 3072 dimensions and cosine similarity. With this in place, our vector database, DataStax AstraDB, can then organize and search through the content based on meaning. This is powerful for finding specific videos on topics, even if keywords don't match exactly.
As a provider, you can leave Amazon Web Services and then select a region and then create database. This might take a while, so see you soon. Okay, our database has been initialized, so now we need to add some data to this vector database. If you go on Data Explorer, namespace you can leave the default one, we need to create a collection. And as a generation method, I don't want to use Nvidia, but you can try it out. I want to use OpenAI API. But to do this, we need the OpenAI integration. Click here. And then we can add an API key. We need to get the OpenAI API key directly from their website. Here, you can click Dashboard, API Keys. I already have some, but let's create a new one. Give it any name you want. Video search. Create a secret key. And then you can copy and save this key somewhere. We'll use this in our project. Let's give a name to this API key. For example, videos API. We can paste
the OpenAI API key, and then we can add the databases to scope, for example, the one we just created, the VideosDB. Add the API key. Okay, perfect. Let's go back to VideosDB, Data Explorer. Now let's create a collection. VideosDB as a collection name, OpenAI as embedding generation method, API key Videos API, and as embedding model, you can choose as option 3 large and dimension 3072 cosine.
And these settings should be fine to start, but you may have to tweak them over time. For now, it's not that important to dive into.
This might take some seconds. Perfect, the collection has been created.
Alright, now that we understand the vector databases, it's time to set up an API we can use. For this, we'll use Langflow, a tool provided by DataStax. Langflow will help us interact with our vector database by creating an easy-to-use API. This will allow us to query our data and retrieve the relevant video information we are after. Now that we're working with Langflow, let's talk about RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation. In simple terms, RAG combines the power of information retrieval with language generation, so we can pull up accurate information and use it to generate helpful, contextually relevant answers or insights. Within Langflow, we are using the vector RAG template, which has two main flows, data ingestion and runtime search experience. In the data ingestion flow, we import all of our video data into the vector database. This creates the embedding we discussed and indexes them for fast retrieval. Then there is the runtime search experience. This part allows users to query for the data where the RAG system retrieves and ranks relevant information for our search. This way, we are not only finding content by keyword, but by meaningful connections in the data. Langflow makes this entire setup more manageable, so we can focus on building our features rather than managing a complex backend.
Now, this is great, but to create a service that uses this database, we need to create an API, right? So now we have multiple options, but I think a great option is to use Langflow. Langflow is another product by DataStax. Let's try it out. At the top left, select Langflow. Here, I already made some tries, but let's create a new project, Vector Store RAG. And here we have this interface that we can use to actually create these APIs in a visual way. It's a very interesting and innovative method.
At the top, you can see the read section, and at the bottom, you can see the ingest section.
Let's go step by step. The first step is to import the CSV file here at the bottom left. Then for OpenAI embeddings, we need to create a credential as a name, Videos API, and as a value, the OpenAI API key, save variable. You can click here just to check if it's working. You can see green check marks. For the AstraDB, choose as a database VideosDB and as a collection VideosDB. They have the same name, it's fine. And this is for the output. Now let's see for the input. You can select here embedding 3 large, OpenAI API key Videos API, chat input. You can leave it as it is for now. AstraDB. VideosDB as a collection and as a database, and be sure to add the AstraDB application token. Parse data, you can leave it as it is. Prompt, you can leave it as it is. And OpenAI, add the OpenAI API key. Click the play button here. Yes, green check mark. And chat output, click here, this is the final one. Yes, it works. So we are ready to test this API. It was that easy to create. And here, for example, I can ask, based on the CSV, give a list of videos about DevOps. And for example, I get 3 videos, but some of them, they have just Docker or Kubernetes in the title. I also made a typo, but it understood the CSV. And this is great. Now we can start creating a frontend based on this API. But where is this API? Here, at the bottom right, we can see a curl. You can generate a token. And this is what we will use to make our HTTP request. We'll create a frontend to consume this API. And the final step is to build a frontend that can consume the API. For this, I've decided to use Next.js, as it's a framework I'm comfortable with. But of course, you can use any frontend technology you prefer, as long as it can make requests to the API created by Langflow. I'll also use Tailwind CSS to style the interface. That's optional. Let's jump right into building it. And now let's create the frontend. You can use any frontend you want. In this case, we will use Next.js. So we can also deploy this to Vercel, and this will be publicly available by the end of this video. I will leave a link below, no worries. npx create next app at latest videos-rag-app --typescript-tailwind. Proceed, yes. Slint, yes. src directory, yes. App router, yes. Import alias, no. And this might take some seconds. See you soon. Step inside this directory and open this with any IDE you want, for example, VS Code. I want to run a quick test, npm run dev. Let's just check it out. And yes, we have a basic Next.js application. In this src folder, let's change the content of the page.tsx file. Let's create an asynchronous function called fetchData. Input value of type string. Let's define a response equal await and a fetch request. And let's import the API Langflow URL as a method post, headers content type application JSON, and as authorization, we can add the token we just generated. As a body, we can return a JSON of input value. We will get this from the user. As output value, chat. Input type, chat. And then if the response is not correct, and in case of error, we can throw a new error with the HTTP status of the response. Otherwise, we can define a variable data, await response.json, and then we can return this data. It's as simple as that. And now export default async function page, search params query string, let response data equal null, and then let error of type string or null equal null, let videos with a title as a string and video ID as a string initialized as empty, let response text of type string initialized as an empty string. This will be the response text from the API. And then if search params.query is not null, try response data equal await fetch data search params query and response text equal response data dot outputs 0 dot outputs 0 question mark dot results question mark dot message question mark dot data question mark dot text. And now I want to use a regular expression to fetch this response and get the video's ID. We will need this to show the thumbnail and the video title on the screen. We can parse the message text to extract these video details. We can have a while loop and push all the videos that have been found inside this array. We will push the title and the video ID. We can add a catch block in case we have an error. And then we can return the HTML part. We will go fast here, but we can return a div. We are using Tailwind here, class name p6, font sans, NH2 as a title, class name text2XL, font bold, text gray 800, MB4 with the title of the page. For example, YouTube videos search. And below we can add a simple form to capture user input.
like this, with this input text and a simple button to search. Below, I can display an error message in case we have an error, of course. And then I want to display the thumbnails of the videos with the title. If we find some videos, we will map this array to some single elements. We can have the title of the video and the default thumbnail. We'll see an example very soon. We are adding some Tailwind classes here just to make it look cool. And in case we can't find any videos, we'll just return a default paragraph. I can also want to display the response text from the API. This might be useful, so I want to leave it here. And here I can leave just this response. Okay, it's time to test it. npm run dev. Let's see how it looks. Okay, the UI is very simple. YouTube video search, enter your query. Let's try, for example, this. Based on CSV, videos about DevOps. Click search. I should probably add a spinner, but here you can see that I can find some videos on my channel related to web development and DevOps. Interesting. Let's try, for example, videos about backend. And here we can see two videos that are indeed about backend, but for example, one is about PHP and one is about Rust. That's great. This does mean that the project is currently checking and fetching from my YouTube channel some videos based on a research on a topic or based on a search on a specific concept that is not necessarily in the title of the video. That's amazing. And that's it. We have reached the end of this tutorial. To make a quick recap, we started by getting a list of all our videos. Then we used AstraDB to set up a vector database. And next, we used Langflow to create an API from our database in a visual and user-friendly way. And finally, we built a simple frontend with Next.js and Tailwind to allow users to search and visualize the API. I hope you found this useful. And if you did, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials like this. See you in the next video. Bye.